Darren Stevens quietened a crowd of 22,000 at the Kia Oval, blasting 90 off 39 balls and taking 4 wickets as Kent Spitfires moved back to the top of the South Group with a 54-run thrashing of Surrey. Sam Northeast batted after winning the toss, but his side lost Joe Denley in the game's first over as he was bowled by an early ball that turned from Zafar Ansari. But Northeast was soon doing what he's been doing all season in this competition, and that's hitting sixes. This his 14th as he moved beyond 500 runs in this tournament this year. He backed that up with a 4 in the same Matt Dunn over, the fourth of the night, going for 14 runs. Northeast and Daniel Bell Drummond are starting to become a good duo, and the latter also hit James Burke out of the park as the Spitfires took 64 runs off the 6 overs of power play. For once, Northeast failed to get to at least a 50. On 32, he lobbed a return catch to Ansari, who was by some way the pick of the home attack, even though he didn't bowl all of his overs. Halfway through their innings, Kent had made a score of 97 for 3, Fabian Cowdery falling for 21 when he sent a ball from Tim Lindley in a very rare T20 outing to Burke in the covers. And when Bell Drummond on 38 drilled a delivery from Burke into the hands of Vikram Solanki, the Spitfires had slipped a bit to 111 for 4 in over number 12. So it was left to Stevens and Alex Blake to start the innings over, and they were soon picking off some boundaries. Kent once again showing the strength of their batting in this form of the game. There can't be many better batting outfits out there. With 4 overs left, the total read 160 for 4, and 71 runs were to follow off the final 4. Stevens started to hit almost every ball he faced to the boundary. 4 fours coming in one Tom Curran over, which had the batsman struggling for form until this night at a 50 off 28 deliveries. 17 runs came off the 17th over, while the next one went for 27. Burke now being sent to all parts of the oval. The first ball of the over was picked up over mid-wicket for 6 by Stevens, who then added 2 more fours, watched a wide go by, and then finished off the over with back-to-back maximums, which brought up the 200. Kent was soon to beat their best ever T20 total, one made earlier this summer in Taunton, a match better known for Chris Gayle's exploits. Another 15 runs were hit off the penultimate over. Stevens now going berserk with 2 more maximums as he raced up to 90 off just 38 deliveries with 10 fours and 5 sixes. This was the Stevens of old, a wonderful way to get back into form. He had 5 balls left to see if he could get to 100, but he found Ben Foulkes at long on to go for 90, the 39-year-old's best effort in this format of the game. It was a hell of a knock. There followed a crazy final 4 deliveries. Blake hit this 4 to move on to 27 after taking a back seat in the 109-run partnership with Stevens. The left-hander then tried to repeat the stroke but gave 17-year-old Sam Curran, brother of Tom, a catch at short third man. The next ball was a wide, and then Ryan Davis smashed his first ever legal delivery in T20 cricket down the ground and over the rope. He was then out to the last ball of the innings with a leading edge off Lindley to Solanki, but Kent had made their highest ever total of 231 for 7 from their 20 overs. Stevens now took the ball, and with his third delivery he flattened Anish Kapil's off stump, the batsman out for a golden duck. With so many players missing from their side, Surrey promoted Tom Curran to the top of the order, and he did a fairly good Jason Roy impression. That was a very big hit. Foulkes tried something similar, as he had to do, but holed out off Ivan Thomas for 10, leaving with his side on 33 for 2 at the start of the fifth over. Curran then played a couple of enormous shots off the same bowler, with a 4 in between, and suddenly we had a game on our hands. 20 runs coming from the fifth over, in spite of that wicket, with Curran, a bowler by trade, rushing up to 39 off 19 deliveries. He had to keep going, whether by hitting long or running hard, and it was trying to do the latter which brought about his downfall. Denley with the accurate throw that had Curran run out for a very entertaining 41. That brought together Gary Wilson and Ansari, and both cleared the rope to take the number of sixes in this exhilarating contest to 13. The very large crowd in South London was certainly getting plenty of value for their money. The ball, after being hit for that six, the bowler retaliated by having Ansari held at cow corner by Thomas. It ended a 59-run partnership, and with Ansari went the game. Matt Coles joined in the fun in the next over as Solanke failed to get out of the way of a well-directed short ball. Wilson, who'd made 55 off 36 balls, top-edged a hoik to Mitch Claydon at fine leg. And when Burke edged to the juggling Davis, Stevens had ended his night with figures of 4 for 39, which had reduced Surrey to 158 for 7 with only 4 overs to go. There wasn't a single boundary off the next three, and then Claydon finished the match off in style. Sam Curran had a swing and a miss. Next ball, Lindley showed all of his stumps to the bowler, who didn't miss them this time either. And to the last ball of the match, Dunn was yorked, Claydon finishing with the fantastic figures of 3 for 16 from his 4 overs, as Surrey ended their 20 on 177 for 9. That gave the Spitfires a victory by 54 runs to send them back to the top of the South Group after Hampshire lost at home to Sussex. That's now 6 wins from 9 and makes the next game at Sussex on July the 3rd a very significant one, as Kent push for a spot in the quarter-finals.